excited to be back here so soon. I just had the privilege of being here with Ruthie Foster. Were you all here? That was some show, huh? And to be here with Tami is a great honor and a privilege. I was sitting with my daughter last night, Sylvia. She just got back from Omaha, Nebraska. I know not too many people fly out to Omaha for 8 days. Her boyfriend's family's from there. And she went thrift shopping and she brought me home these glasses. And she said, "Mom, not too many young women go out and go shopping for their moms and buy them Elvis glasses." And I said, "Well, that's very appropriate because I'm going to be playing at Colonel Tom Parker Press Park this evening." Let's turn on the guitar here. Now I'm going to play different songs than I played the last time. It's my friend Shelly here. There you are. Now she's something sexy. Aren't we all? Well, she's a special something sexy. She's Jackie O in the backseat, minus all the blood, a beauty and a genius, a devastating flood. Get your mind all the twisted, can't see past your nose. That woman's something special. Watch where she go, cause you never get her. No, you just don't get her. She's a phenomenon. She's something sexy, all right, and she's already gone. She's Joan through the fire, the saint beneath the pain. You think that she's an angel, but she tell you that she ain't. Make you feel like a million to realize you're exposed. That woman's something special. Watch where she go, cause you never get her. No, you just don't get her. She's a phenomenon. She's something sexy, all right, and she's already gone. Say goodbye forever to what you never had, never really knowing can't really be that bad. Just don't get her. She's a phenomenon. She's something sexy, all right, and she's already gone. She's every sacred Mary, reverence versus lust, ashes to ashes, envy to disgust. Boy, don't beat yourself to death, cause heaven only knows that woman's something special. Watch where she goes, and you never get her. You just don't get her. She's a phenomenon. She's something sexy, all right, and she's already gone. She's something sexy, all right, and she's already gone. She's some sexy old rat. What is she? That's right, she's already gone. That's right. She sees it all plain as day. Never mind, never saw what you don't know can hurt so bad. Don't talk about it, don't make a sound, Don't scream or shout it now. Who is she? Can't be me. Better go figure it out for yourself. What's mine is mine, so get in line. When did it all get so sad? Don't talk about it. Don't make a sound. Don't scream or shout it out loud. Who's casting stones and committing sin? Why can't you open your heart and let love in? 'Cause all the while, little child, big baby girl, hold your head up high. The signs, now's the time. Here comes your big breakdown. Don't talk about it. Don't make a sound. Don't scream or shout it. You know it gets tied up inside of the child. It just keeps on crying till you pick it up. That ain't enough. Baby needs love. We all need just a little bit of love. Thank you. Thank you. Both of those songs that I just played are on different records, but you can get them on CD over there. And that song, Don't, is off of Maybe in the Morning, and that's on vinyl as well. I'm gonna play a song I haven't recorded yet. Oh, I can go on like this. Everything you break, I fix. I'm in the land of the nearly missed, almost there. And while the sun still comes up, it doesn't smile on me enough to feel the warmth of love's tender kiss. It's dearly missed. I deserve more than your offering. I deserve every sweet thing. Push, go on and push yourself to take that smile off the shelf. It suits you well, and I love to see you loving me, yeah. And while these tears fall from my eyes, I still see stars when you arise. Every new day is another chance. Come on, romance. I deserve more than you're offering. I deserve every sweet thing. I deserve more than you're offering. I deserve every sweet thing. I shouldn't have to ask. You really should know how lucky you are. Well, maybe I should go home. I won't go on like this. I need a partner who gives to feel the joys of all of this. Come on, let's kiss. I deserve more than you're offering. I deserve every sweet thing. I deserve more than you're offering. I deserve every sweet thing. Don't you agree? Sweet thing, now give it to me. Sweet thing. Thank you. Thank you so much. Wow, I've never played that live before. I should really record that song. I'm gonna play a song for Tommy. My friend Tommy's here. He likes this song. Now this song's called Give Me Back My Love, which is actually kind of in the same vein of I deserve more than you're offering, don't you agree? Now give it to me, right Tommy? Where are you?
Right here.
There you are. I'm looking for you, but I got this light in my eye. I can't see your handsomeness. And this song, Give Me Back My Love, is that's off a record of mine called Razor Blade Smile. Produced by Mr. Eric Roscoe Amble. I know, give it up for him, right? I don't usually do this as a solo thing, but I'll do anything for Tommy. Troubled and beautiful you are, I fall down on my knees, awaken my disease. Cut me down, tearing up my heart, bringing me to tears and raising up old fears. I give you love, you who give me a hard time. I give you love, you who give me a hard time. I give you love, you give me a hard time. Give me back my love, give me back my love, give me back my love. An open wound, festering and deep, poke it with a stick until you make it bleed. So gather round, witness my defeat, with your angry eyes so blue and bitter sweet. I give you love, you who give me a hard time. I give you love, you who give me a hard time. I give you love, you give me a hard time. Give me back my love, give me back my love, give me back my love. Boy, you just can't know exactly what you stole. What's been broken here might never again be whole. Crippled and comical you are, so heartless to the core, it makes me want you more. Crazy and totally bizarre, this love is just insane. Now something's gotta change. I give you love, you who give me a hard time. I give you love, you who give me a hard time. I give you love, you give me a hard time. Give me back my love, give me back my love, give me back my love. I give you love, you who give me a hard time. Give you love, you give me a hard time. Give me back my love, give me back my love, give me back my love. Love. Thank you so much. How am I doing for time? I got one more, two more. Do I have one more song? I have two more songs. Oh, okay. Five more? Oh, that's sweet. I'm gonna play a song called Easy Go. And I wasn't planning on doing that. Should I do Easy Go or should I do The Devil? The Devil Knows My Name. Devil Knows My Name. Okay. I'll do The Devil Knows My Name. And then I think I'm gonna end with somebody else's song. I'm a songwriter, that's what I do. That's why I dress like Dan Penn, because I'm a songwriter. Shelly, you get that, don't you? It's a little humid. So I'm gonna play this song called The Devil Knows My Name. It's kind of a rock song. I write rock songs. I write all kinds of songs. It must be Monday, 'cause I don't wanna get out of bed feeling so lazy. Just stare at the ceiling instead, just like the old day. Thinking and feeling no pain, it makes no difference, 'cause every stupid day is the same. I'm on the list, I don't miss, I can't the dumb, I cry my through the time, I'm not to blame, no one's to blame. The devil know my name, some call this living, but you might as well lay down and die, it ain't for sissies. The deck is stacked so rough, don't even try, running on a treadmill. But a loser's game, they don't give prizes for being sad, angry, lonely, and lame. I'm on the list, I can't be missed, I don't crime, I do my time, no, I'm a whale, I'm stuck in it, no one's to blame. Devil know my name. Playing songs I never play. I'm gonna do somebody else's song, and then we're gonna bring out the great Tami Neilson. I am so excited to see Tami. I was like literally vibrating when we pulled up in the car. I was like this. I love her. I think she's got one of the greatest voices, and I just love her whole vibe. And she's awesome, and she's a mom like me, and she's doing what she does, and she does, you know, she plays music with her family, and it's just cool. I'm gonna do a cover of a song that you probably know really, really well, but I'm gonna do my version of it, and you'll know why I'm doing it. Rolled into Nazareth, I was feeling about half past dead. I just need a place where I could lay my head. Mister, can you tell me where a man might find a bed? Just shook my head, no was all he said. Take a load off Fanny, take a load for free. Take a load off Fanny, hey. You put the load right on me. Picked up my bag, I went looking for a place to hide. When I saw Carmen and the devil walking side by side, I said, hey Carmen, come on, let's go downtown. She said, I gotta go, but my friend can't stick around. Take a load off Fanny, take a load for free. Take a load off Fanny, hey, you put the load right on me, yeah. Go down, Miss Moses, well, there's nothing you can see. Well, it's just old Luke and Luke waiting on a judgment day. Hey, Luke, my friend, what about young Emily? You said, do me a favor, boy, won't you stay and keep Emily company? Take a load off Fanny, take a load for Frey. Take a load off Fanny, hey, you put the load right on me, yeah. Crazy chest followed me, and he caught me in the fog. Said, I will fix your rack if you take Jack my dog. Hey, wait a minute, Chester, you see I'm a peaceful man. He said, that's okay, boy, just feed him when you can. Take a load off Fanny, take a load for free. Take a load off Fanny, and you put the load right on me, yeah. Cast a cannonball now, take me down line. My bag is singing low, and I do believe it's time. Get me back to Miss Fanny, you know she's the only one who sent me here with the regards for everyone. Take a load off Fanny, take a load. Take a load off Fanny, hey, you put the load right on me, yeah. You put the load right on me, oh, Miss Fanny.
Good night, y'all. My name is Emily Duff. Get ready. Tami Neilson's coming. And God bless Robbie Robertson. Thank y'all very much.
But it ain't my job. You tell me at my age, but don't you dare look it. Proper, but it ain't my job.
Again, do you guys, were any of you here the first time? Well, the only other time I was here. Oh yeah, you're gluttons for punishment. We got rained out last time. We had to go in like this gigantic gymnasium or theater in the school. It was the school where who was the famous person? Jay. It was the highlight of Jay's life. Richie Sambora went there, right? Oh, well, it's good to be here. And oh my god, it's so weird not to see you guys. We're not usually headliners, so we get to see everyone in the daytime normally. Which, you know, it has its awkwardness, but also its benefits of getting to see, you know, like people's expressions. But it's a little bit like, I don't know, doing daytime gigs, it's kind of like kissing with your eyes open. It can be incredibly awkward. You know, still nice, but awkward. thank you so much. I forgot to say, how amazing is Emily Duff? Like, is she not the coolest? She's totally the coolest. I like want to be her bestie now. I feel like we bonded over the rice and beans back there. We totally did. And beans, we're going to bond even more after. I'm sorry. I am a professional. Thank you so much. Well, I want to introduce you to these lovely boys up here with me. Can you please give a big hand for Kevin McGowan on the drums? And the one who's just like, no offense to Kevin, but like just slightly better looking. And that's just because he kind of looks like me. This is my little brother, Jay Neilson, on the guitar. So rude, eh? Kevin's used to it now. He's just like, you guys, honestly, being the unrelated one, it's just not fair, you know. That said, I love my brother, but can you turn his guitar down in my wedge a little bit? It's just a little overpowering. overpowering my vocals. And we can't have that, can we? No. Can you turn that down as well? It's a little bit overpowering my vocals as well. My heart is a beep, beep, beating inside my chest. Until I get you loving, I won't get no rest. No matter what you say or do, oh, what kind of hell you gonna put me through? I'm gonna walk, walk, walk back to your arms. Walk, walk. Yeah, you're gonna talk, talk, talk with all your charm. This is our very last show in the United States. We saved the best for last, guys. We've been on tour through the States. As it was said earlier, I live in New Zealand now, even though I'm originally from Canada. Do we have a New Zealander here? Or just someone who likes New Zealand?
Good.
Yeah, yeah. And this has kind of been like a once in a lifetime adventure. I have my two little boys, Charlie and Sam, with me. They're 11 and 9. And my husband, who has been driving for the past 5 months, we picked up an RV on the West Coast at the first week of April. And we have driven all the way across to New York, and then up to Prince Edward Island, across back to Alberta, and then Montana, and then we've headed down. Right now they're in Vegas. I flew out today for this, and I'll head back to them tomorrow. It was It was a bit, my husband was like, I can't make it in that short amount of time, all the way back to New Jersey after we've just driven across the country. So I flew out, but it's been quite the adventure. You know, we kind of had this little window of opportunity. I said, like, the kids, they're 9 and 11. They still think we're cool. And they want to hang out with us. And I can see the writing on the wall that that's going to, you know, it's going to shift very soon, like probably in the next year with the 11-year-old. Like, they want to hang out with his friends more than he wants to hang out with us. So this was kind of that little golden window. And I've always wanted them to spend more than just a couple weeks visiting family. And so they've gotten to have this epic adventure traveling across North America and back again. And so I'm going to dedicate this song to them. This song is called Hey Bus Driver. I dedicate it to my husband, who has done all the driving on the other side of the road, by the way, for him, a New Zealander. And first time driving a 36-foot motorhome on the other side of the road. So, yes, good luck to him. He's done very well. And I said to him when we talked about doing this, I'm like, if we're gonna do this motorhome thing, like, you're doing all the driving. Because, like, he's not here, I'm a terrible driver. And this is not leaving. This is a circle of trust here. Not leaving here. Don't tell him I said that. But between us, I'm a terrible driver. So he's done all the driving. God bless him. And it's been an incredible journey. My kids are going to be, they're like, we don't want to leave America. Everything's bigger here. You get free refills of your fizzy drinks. That's all that matters. Free refills of fizzy drinks. Like, to show the commitment, I actually even got, like, a little tattoo of, this is our RV. And it's kind of a full circle moment. Jay and I actually grew up in a family band with our mom and our dad. and our youngest brother, Todd. And we grew up in it was only like a 30 foot though, right? 34 foot. And we were teenagers. Very different story. My parents, like, I don't know, they should be getting some sort of medal of bravery for doing that. But yeah, so it's kind of this full circle. And if you'd ever told me that I would be doing it with my family, I would have laughed. And I already know this is going to cost a lot in therapy. But enjoying it at the moment, though. Well, this next song is one that is has been a really cool little thing happened last year. We have this TV show in New Zealand called The Brokenwood Mysteries. This one person likes it. That's how you found me. Yay. See, guys? She found me there. It's all worth it. But if you haven't seen The Brokenwood Mysteries, I think it's on Acorn in the States, say, yeah. And it's hard to explain. It's a murder mystery, but it's cute. It's quirky. It's cute. And it's kind of quaint and sweet. And, you know, it's just, unfortunately, people get murdered. And it's like this really, really, it's set in this tiny, tiny rural town in New Zealand. And I don't know how they keep their population up because people die weekly. And they're in like their 10th season. So for 10 years, people have just been dropping like flies. And people still live there and move there,
that's
apparently.
520 people.
That's 520 people. You've counted how many? Yeah. No, it's not 52 seasons. Like
52 weeks.
50 shows.
Let's just say.
No, it's not. It's like a season. But anyway, he's a musician. He's not good at math. But it's still a lot of people to die in a very tiny town. But they make it cute, you know? And so for 10 years, they've used a lot of my music through the series, and Jay and I even scored the second season, did the whole like score for it, and so I finally got the call I've been waiting for in their last season. I think it was the 8th season. They said, we've actually written like a guest cameo appearance for you, right? And I was like, oh my God, like I've been training for this my whole life. Because, you know, like you watch those murder mystery shows and it always shows like the dead person on the table and you just sit there and you watch their chest. You do it, right? Like you watch and you're like, how good of an actor are you? And you're like, I could do it better. I could do that better. And I've been training since I was a kid to like hold my breath. I'm a singer, I got good breath control. And so I'm like, put me in, coach. I'm like, how do I die? And he was like, oh, well, you don't die. Right? And I'm like, well, then what am I? And he's like, you're a singer. So lame. But I mean, like, I've been trying to say, like, I'm still alive, so there's still hope that they could kill me in a different episode. You know, it's dangerous being a musician. There's many ways it could happen. But anyway, I still hold out hope. But apparently, you know, Brokenwood is also where dreams go to die. And I was just a singer singing this song. Here we go.
No plastic bags on the shoes. Papa selling houses, sleeping in the car. Four babies in the backseat, underneath the stars. Well, hey, hey, just work a little harder. Hey, hey, punching that clock with a work and prayer and a little bit of make so much money, need a 10-ton truck. Well, ha, 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 ha.
truck quail. Already. Oh, I think my guitar, if you could just mute my guitar, please. Thank you. You give a big hand for our awesome sound crew tonight. Honestly, doing these shows is just such a delight. You guys have such a wonderful community here. What an awesome event to be able to come out to. You guys are spoiled. Well, as I said, I grew up singing in a family band, and this song is kind of a little mini autobiography of growing up in music, and particularly country music. I grew up singing, and I've loved country music my whole life, and it was, you know, it's such a part of my DNA, it's in my blood, and as I got older, you know, all the things in life where you think, if I just work hard enough, and if I keep, you know, going at my skill and perfecting my skill, and just don't give up and keep going, I will get these opportunities, and the gatekeeper, the one who holds the key, will open a door, and I'll make it, and it'll all happen, you know. And as the years go by and you get older and you start to see that the world doesn't work that way, but in particular the music industry doesn't work that way, unfortunately. And I love country music, but quickly found out it doesn't love me back. And you know, when you look at the statistics, in 2022, only last year, only 10% of country music radio across North America is made up of women. Only 10% of country music radio is made up of women. That's just mind-blowing to me that in this day and age that we're still so far away from that equality, and not even having more. We just want the same, you know, getting those same opportunities. And you know what, it's, you kind of realize that, hold on, like it's not these gatekeepers that hold this power, because the way that we change those things, we're not gonna change the system, unfortunately. People benefit off that system, and they don't have any reason to change it when they're benefiting from it. But what we can do is, you know, you guys are all here tonight to see a female headliner. And when you support female artists, a female support act, buy the merch, you buy tickets to their shows, you listen to their music, you support them online, you follow them, that's how we make a change. It's bypassing that whole old broken system. And you guys, the audience, holds that power. And so thank you so much for coming tonight to see some female artists. God is in the garden, devil's in the dirt. Eve is picking apples, Adam's blaming her. Daddy was a guitar, mama was a gun. King of country music, the daughter not the son. Daughter not the son, daughter not the son. Could the king of country music be the daughter not the son? Got me some cows and I got me some chickens. Got me a dog and a guitar for picking fights with folks who try to cut the string on my kite. That's right. No southern drawling, no grits from grandma. 8,000 miles more south of Alabama, you can bet. Most famous girl ain't no one heard of yet, but I'm all set. Unbroken next to her. Sometimes that country music pedigree is earned. You watch and learn. Nashville Trailer Park, I was 17. Family band, Opryland, playing sets between. Writing songs, slipping demo tapes in laundry bags of stars. You don't get far. Above my station anyway. Pardon me while I rearrange the furniture. Well, speaking of kings of country music, this next song is one that, you know, you're not, it's, choosing like a favorite song is like choosing a favorite kid, you know? Like, we all have one, but we just don't say it. I'm just kidding. I can make that joke because my kids aren't here. But this song holds a very, very special place and could possibly be my favorite. It's one that, you know, Jay and I lost our dad 8 years ago. And I was talking to a friend who had recently lost his father as well. And we were just talking about that, that moment, you know, when you have a dream of someone that you've lost, and it's almost like you get this stolen extra time with them. And I don't have dreams of my dad very often. I wish I did. But I kind of wanted to capture that feeling of, like, having this dream, spending time with them, and not wanting to leave that moment. And so I wrote this song with my friend Delaney Davidson. And when it came to record the song, the first verse is me singing to my dad, and then the second verse is him singing to me. And I thought, you know, who on earth could possibly fill the shoes of my dad, you know, and be his voice in this song? And so I thought, you know, I'm just going to go to the very top and see if he says yes. And as it turns out, he did. So Willie Nelson did sing the voice, the part of my dad in this song. And I know that some of you don't believe me. I can feel the doubt. I know we just met. But I do have proof. And it's on my CD over there. If you need that proof, you can buy it. I'm sorry. Anyway. So he was, Willie was incredibly generous to say yes and do this duet with me. Unfortunately, he could not make it tonight. I know, I could feel a little anticipation. I just thought I'd kind of burst that bubble before it got too big. But in the absence of a Nelson, a Neilson will have to do. So I'm gonna do this song for our dad. It's my little brother here.
Last night I woke from a dream, you and me were together. Tears on my face when I realized that we're still apart. I close my eyes and I try to go back to my slumber. The only place that you exist now since you did depart. Beyond the stars I can hear the guitars. They're calling me up to be with you. Darling, will you and I dance to the beat of our heart? To the place where I can't believe that you will never leave me alone in the dark. Take me away to the place you are beyond.
Of indigo, and come and go with me. Follow me up past the moonlight and beyond the sky. I won't let the breath leave my chest without taking you with me. Here in my heart, we will never depart. Darling, we'll fly.
Beyond the stars, I can hear the guitars.
They're calling me up to be with you.
To the place where I can't believe.
The heat off the asphalt quivers like a people dancing while she sings. Looking at her like she's a lottery ticket or a horse that's gonna win up the bet. Hey, you got nowhere to pick them before that you're gonna see. Green peaches, steal them right off the tree. He says, don't worry, honey, I'll take care of the money. And he picks up a check for their estates. In the back of his car, he says, I'll make you a star, girl. Don't worry about a thing. And she thinks of the years and the tears spent wishing for the day someone would say those words. She softly cries and puts his hand on her thigh and says, ain't no one like you in this whole wide world. Walking with the baby when she stopped by a lady. Ain't you that girl? Had a hit or two. And she shakes her head and says, sorry, ma'am, I'm afraid that girl sure isn't me. But I get it all the time. The baby starts to cry and she lullabies him that melody. Oh, you got nowhere to pick them before.
I thought that I had finished writing all the songs from my last album, and it was a week before I was going into the studio, and a girlfriend sent me this article from 1938, and it was entitled Dating Tips for Women. And as you can imagine, it was so wonderful and heartwarming. Some of these tips were, don't talk while you're dancing, for a man doesn't want to hear what's in your head, he just wants to dance. Only a careless woman would behave this way. And there were like photographs of this couple in 1938 illustrating and demonstrating what not to do on these dates. And so it showed the woman like checking her lipstick in the rear view mirror of his car and speaking to other people on their date and not wearing a girdle. And she was, and drinking too much. So she was quickly becoming my hero. I was reading it and laughing as I was reading it. And then I started to have like this fire just start burning in me. And I'm like, why am I so upset by this? And I realized that, you know, this was the way that my grandmother was taught to behave. And then my mother taught, she taught my mother. And then my mother taught me. And this is still a poison that runs through our society, the way that we expect our young women coming up to behave. And I see a lot of those changes, a lot of those things are starting to break. And it's a really beautiful, beautiful thing to see. But I started to think more about those that word careless, and how it was this seen as this negative thing. And I stood up at my desk and I started stomping and clapping, and all these words came out. And I thought, yes, like careless. Like, I want to care less. Come on, clap with me. A careless woman, she played too rough, she laughed too loud, talked too much, too much, too much. She just too much. I want to be her when I grow up. I want to be her when I grow up. Smile, smile, girl, you better smile. Show me what I want, know what you're feeling on the inside. Dance, dance, girl, you better dance. Don't talk like you got any thoughts in your head. I want to care less. 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 A careless woman, she played too rough. She laughed too loud. Talked too much, too much, too much. She just too much. I want to be her when I grow up. I want to be her when I grow up. Cry, cry, you better not cry. Don't make me look bad in front of all the guys. Mine, mine, your body is mine. To play with it, legislated, honey, I'll decide. I want to care less. 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 A careless woman, she played too rough. She laughed too loud. Talked too much, too much, too much. She just too much. I want to be her when I grow up. I want to be her when I grow up. I want to be her. Woman sticker, and I think you earned it. It's a badge of honor. I wrote this song about Dolly Parton because I'm a fangirl and I love her. And I want her to adopt me forever and ever. And I was reading her autobiography, and there's a chapter all about doing business. And what a savvy businesswoman she is. And she said, you know, many an old boy have underestimated me because I look like a woman and I'm soft like a woman, but I do business like a man. And she's a pistol, that girl. So this song is called Baby, You're a Gun.
Mother, soft Well, he's working the room and his voice goes boom and he's drowning out the thoughtful conversation. He says, listen up, honey, I was only being funny. Don't start with your feminist condemnation. Well, he flies through the vultures and he cries, cancel culture anytime you try to call him out. He storms, he rages, like manners are contagious. Honey, turn the volume down. Shh, mama's talking. Mama's talking. All the oxygen you hog while you're playing top dog. Honey's growing thinner than your hairline. Dinosaurs became extinct. And that caveman way you think is gonna walk you off the edge of our timeline. Cause the world ain't flat and a woman ain't a doormat. Even underneath your feet. So before you interrupt, to the good old
Well, this is another one for my dad, and actually by my dad. You know, when you lose somebody, you also grieve all of the things that you did with that person, all those things that you did together that you won't get to do again. And I never thought that I would get to write a song with my dad again. And my mom was going through some of his old work tapes and found a box of his old work tapes and gave them to Jay, and he went through and listened, and he found this little snippet of a melody and some music, and he texted it to me. He's like, I think this is for you. And I listened to it, and it was Dad kind of singing gibberish and playing his guitar, and at one point he got to this really high part and his voice cracked and he's like, oh, what am I doing? This is too high. And I laughed and I'm like, well, that's because it's for me, Dad. And I immediately started to cry because it felt like in that moment we were having a conversation and we were writing together again. And so I finished that song, and this one's for Dad. This is his song.
Set me free, I am begging you, let me
That bug was no good for my soul. Little protein, though. Never hurt anyone.
Thank you.
losing my mind from losing your love. Raising my eyes to the sky above, but I don't find nothing. I don't feel not there, my Lord. No time to cry when the baby sees green. That day's flying by with nothing. You're between them. My soul is wearing thin. Time stretches on a fool's baby thong. Ever since the day you died, holy Moses.
Well, thank you guys so much for coming out tonight and supporting the arts. And thank you for being so kind to us. And hopefully it's not as long a gap until we see you again. We're going to finish off with this one.
Take my heart, it used to be so supple and sweet. Now it's withered on the vine. There's before, and then there's after. You were mine. So strong and full of fire. Now it's bruised, broken down, and blind. There's before, and then there's after. You were mine. Keeps going and around, and around. Got hands on the clock, going tick tock, tick tock. Ain't no
You guys are so greedy. I love that. I love that in an audience. Well, Jay and I are going to close the night with a little lullaby for you guys. And this is how we started off singing, just the two of us. Singing with a guitar. Good night.